You know what I thought the first time I met you?
It's like the guy vanished in thin air.
Man, it comes easy for that guy.
I assume you got some evidence that supports that theory?
Got it, thanks.
Hear what? The sound of evidence being destroyed is coming from inside that building.
Hope that's not evidence you're destroying.
You can never just drop anything, can you?
Not one of my particular strengths, no.
Evidence of a bad idea.
Well, I'm sorry.
Halt!
Doesn't come that easy to the rest of us.
You're uncomfortable with the lie that we've told. You shouldn't be.
Easy for you to say.
Why? Because I'm a mere consultant and you're a real policeman.
You know if you fired a gun in here, I could arrest you?
I do.
Bell.
Detective Bell. Sorry I'm late.
But did I mischaracterize your professionalism?
Everything okay? You mischaracterized our relationship.
It's Marcus.
It's a bet for me. I didn't sleep last night.
You know, there are people who work this stuff full time. Don't you think they would have found it by now?
People, Detective Bell, are not you and me.
This is a pep talk. It means work. And I'm not you.
I am a drug addict, Marcus. A drug addict.
You heard about Marcus Bell's complications, I take it?
Yes, of course. I hate what happened to you and whatever role I played in it.
You were going to throw away your career.
No, I wasn't going to let that happen.
So you decided to go down with me. It's not a pep talk. With help, I fought back.
I don't want a favor from you. I'd rather not see it around here.
Marcus.
Detective Bell is several standard deviations above the norm. I have always regarded him as such.